website. So the next is this one, but I will have a poll related to the next case, but first I present okay, this was presented also in the short summary in the presentation. The issue is the judgment of the shape of this lesion. So this is so okay, the borders are irregular, okay, but now focus on the shape. So in this section, the nodule seems to have more depth than width, but indeed at the largest depth, largest width clearly exceeded the depths. I will present in image form after the video. So the first was the taller than wide, and in the longitudinal section now the issue is whether this is longer than wide shape. Now back to the longitudinal scan. Now the longitudinal scan. So it seems to have much greater diameter in the anterior posterior than in the upper to lower section. So it seems to have longer than wide sign, but here this large nodule compressed this nodule. So I don't think that this should be regarded as a abnormal or non-parallel orientation. Nevertheless, it is a deeply hypoechlesian. It should be aspirated. So this is not a very important question whether this lesion has a taller than wide shape. It was only an illustration that we should measure in the transverse scan the largest width, and it should be compared to the largest depth and not in a single section. But this nodule has also irregular lobulated margins. I think it is not a question, it is evident that this nodule is not a regular one. The final histopathology proved to be a benign lesion, a non-tumorous lesion in this one, and the larger proved to be a follicular adenoma, and this was a non-tumorous lesion. By the way, it is very not very, it is a suspicious one. So this is not one undulation. The entire nodule has multiple lobulations, and here also maybe a speculation. So this is clearly an irregular border. I don't think that it can be disputed, and this case would not belong to those one in which the interpretations would differ. Comments or questions related to this case?
I have one question.
Please?
Yes. This node could be a parathyroid gland.
Parathyroid?
It's lower. Yes. Because it is very low, lower in the pole.
Yes, you are right. I cannot remember what was my thought about this one. I know that this patient proved to have a hyperplasia, or how is it in French, that non-tumorous thyroid lesion. And the larger proved to be an adenoma. So it is really suspicious that it could be a parathyroid, but a parathyroid lesion, I have thought I saw two parathyroid cancers and many parathyroid adenomas, but even the cancers did not have such irregular shape. I don't think a parathyroid adenoma is almost always oval or round, much more frequently oval. Such irregularities, I think, argue against being this lesion parathyroid adenoma, despite, and you are absolutely right, the location, on the location, we should consider the presence of parathyroid adenoma.
Carcinoma,
could be. Parathyroid cancer is a very rare disease. I don't know how much were presented in the literature. I met two patients in my practice with parathyroid cancer, primary, and I met some with recurrent forms, but the primary diagnosis was in my practice two cases, and it should compare to several hundreds of parathyroid adenomas. So I don't think that we have enough patients to draw real consequences, but my opinion is that such lesion with such a form is rarely a parathyroid. And one more comment. This large nodule compresses this smaller one. These are within the same thyroid pseudocapsule. A parathyroid adenoma would locate it outside the thyroid and would be less affected by this compressive sign. So this is a sac, this is a bag, and within the bag there is a large and a smaller nodule, but the parathyroid adenoma would locate it outside the bag and could not make such a great impact on a neighboring. Okay, it is not an absolute meaning, so I don't think that I am right. Surely right, but I think that this is also a circumstance which should be taken into account. Other comments, questions related, please? No?
Please. Small comments,
please.
If possible.
Yeah.
Regarding the parathyroid lesion question, parathyroid adenomas may be located in the thyroid. This is possible, as you have mentioned.
Yes.
But regarding the parathyroid carcinoma issue, as parathyroid carcinomas are neuroendocrine tumors, they are presenting with their metastasis, not as invasive lesions. So, seeing an invasive lesion, I mean, a speculated lesion like this, in my opinion, does not imply a parathyroid carcinoma.
Okay.
Do you agree with?
Okay, I think you are right. And I think that we deal with pathologies with different probability. If the cytology would not confirm a thyroid origin, in this case, naturally we had to move further, defining the washout content of this lesion. But if we perform the FNA and it disclosed a thyroid origin in this hyperacute lesion, then not to deal with. Absolutely right. We should consider the possibility of parathyroid in this lesion, and if the FNA would not confirm thyroid origin, then we had to make another diagnostic steps.